Changing object duration is a simple but must-to-know task when working with ActivePresenter. It helps you to fine-tune the timing of different objects on a slide. Sometimes, it supports you in creating a simple animation. Let's explore two ways to do that in today's video. The first way is to adjust the properties in the timing section. Besides, you can drag object time bars in the timeline pane. Let's start with the first way. At first, let's open the Insert tab to insert an object. As you can see, when you insert a new object, by default, its start time is also the slide starts time. As this checkbox is ticked by default, the object will be shown to the end of the slide. When you drag the red stripe to change the slide duration, the object duration will change accordingly. You can adjust these default values as you wish. In the timing section of the Size and Properties tab, you can change the object start time by adjusting the value in this spin box. To change its duration, clear this checkbox. Thanks to that, the duration spin box is enabled and lets you change the value. As you can see, the object time bar in the timeline pane will change accordingly. Select the checkbox again if you want to display the object to the end of the slide. Now, let's explore the second way. First, place the playhead at the timestamp you want the objects to appear. For example, at the 6th second. Open the Insert tab to insert any type of objects you wish. By doing so, you will see their time bars in the timeline pane. Besides, their start time in the timing section is automatically updated. Drag its two sides to change the start time and the ending time correspondingly. As you can see, the values in the spin boxes will change accordingly. You can also drag the object time bar to the position you want. Open the Animations tab, add an entrance effect to those objects to create a simple animation. Let's see what happens. That's it.